Hey guys, I'm Code to Zero and I'm going to try a new type of content. I'm going to discuss the upcoming units to global. This time around I'm going to start with the G4 badge, including the captain of UC G4, and the upcoming new color, which is Timescape Color Kit. There's another new character coming to the Colosseum, but it's an old one, so I'm not going to bother obviously with him. Yeah, here we have the first one, obviously the legend of the badge. Well, one of the legends of the badge, which is G4 Luffy. G4 Luffy version 2. This is one of the best characters, top 1, top 2 of the best captains in the game, basically. Let's start with it. As any Luffy, fighter, free spirit, very old already, quite quick, 5 combo and 5 slots. Okay, the stats. Yeah, he's a beast. He's a beast. He has, with Candice, he's going to have 5k HP, more than 5k HP, more than 2k attack. It's completely broken stats wise. Okay. Now, the captain ability, this is the gimmick of this unit, which is that as a base without doing anything, He always boosts the HP from around characters by 125 and boosts chances of getting strange, quick and PSI orbs. So it's pretty good because it's already good start. Now, if you are in gear 2, which is the base form, boost the attack of all characters by 3 times. Also boosts a bit chances of recovery orbs and makes quick beneficial for other characters. If you switch to Gear 3 Captain, which is basically swapping the character, like if you swap it a dual unit, but you don't need any kind of resource to do this, you boost the attack of all characters by 3.5, sorry. After 2 perfects, so the first 2 units don't have any boost, boost chances of getting recovery orbs and makes the strangers beneficial for our characters. Okay, so this Luffy basically has 2 forms without any or you can swap between them without any kind of resource that boosts 3 times all units or 3.5 after 2 perfects. And makes 2 of the orbs that they make appear more matching. Okay, now there's 2 gear 4 transformations and I'm going to explain how they work. Basically, when you use the special or you, like I said it here, you kill an enemy, you get gear power gauge. So when your gear power gauge, when you use the special or you switch your captain and the gear gauge is full, you will switch to a gear 4 form instead. So like Luffy Ace and like the old G4, if you use the special you will transform directly to G4, but you can also transform directly to G4 if you load your gear power by killing enemies and then you swap, you will turn to one of the G4 forms. When you are on G4 you will lose gear for every turn that passes. And when you lose all the gear, it will go back to zero and you will go back to the old form. So, what are the G4 forms of this Luffy? The first one, which is going to be the most common one, boosts attack of all characters by 4x, reduces damage received by 20%, boosts chances of getting recovery orbs, and makes strange, quick and PSI orbs beneficial for other characters. That paired it with the always active Captain ability. So basically, he's a beast. Because he becomes 4x while reducing damage and also makes the orbs that he makes appear more beneficial. The second form is the Gear 4 Tankman Captain. This form is harder to get because you need to eat recovery orbs before transforming, and you need to eat like I don't know how it says it here. Is it here? I think it was like 8 meat orbs, I think. So like it says here, based on how full gear power Gouge is, it transforms Luffy. If gear power is above 50%, change between gear 2 and gear 3. If gear power is full, change into gear 4 Bondman. And if you have the meats, you have consumed meats, you will become Tankman. Tankman is even better because he boosts the Luffy by 425, the rest by 4, reduces damage by 50% and makes the orbs matching. This is basically like a better, to say it plainly, a better and rainbow G4 B1. This is G4 B1 on steroids. Because as a base, he has more damage, he makes some orbs beneficial, he can switch on two modes depending on what you need, and when you use his special, or you don't need his special, when you load the gear power, you can transform and have 4x for 3 turns easily and make orbs matching still. So basically how I would resume this unit would be as a way better and rainbow G4. As simple as that. Also, why he's much better than G4? Because his special doesn't, besides you not needing his special to transform him, you can also, if you use his special is good. It doesn't work only for transforming him. Because he gets 150 character attack to all enemies, boost the attack of all characters by 2 times for 1 turn. This is the best rainbow boost in the game, 2 times for everyone without any condition. Makes recovery and tandem beneficial for all characters for 3 turns, so more matching orbs. And in Luffy, if you are not transforming into Gear 4, you will transform into Gear 4 directly. Ah, you need to eat 10 meats. 10 meats, okay, 10 meats. And all of this with a 13 turn cooldown. As a limit break ability, spin scaling, spin self reduction, and critical hit. He doesn't even need them. This is, like I said, one of the best captains in the game, along Warco. So yeah, if you want to pull for him, pull, because this is like the best, one of the best units you will have in a while. Okay, I didn't put Nami here, so let's look for, I forgot about Nami completely. So let's look for her here. We also get a second legend in this Sugo Fest, new legend, which is Nami, Nami fan service version. Because the first start is not fan service. Well, maybe just a bit. No, not even fan service. The second art, total fan service. Good job, Banco. She's a Cerebral Striker with 5 combo, 5 slots. She has decent stats. She doesn't have as much HP and attack as before, but she has good stats. She can be useful. Her captain ability. Reduces cooldown of all specials by 1 turn at the start of the fight. Boost attack of Dex character by 375. And makes strength and quick corps beneficial for Dex character. Translation. Mono Dex captain. 375 is very good. But there's not too many occasions where you're going to use Nami as a captain. Doesn't mean that she's bad at all, because she has one of the best specials in the game for damage boosting purpose, and we're going to say it now. If your captain is a Free Spirit, Cerebral, Powerhouse or Driven, boost the color affinity of Free Spirit, Cerebral, Powerhouse or Driven characters by 175 for 1 turn, and amplifies the effect slots for Free Spirit, Cerebral, Powerhouse and Driven characters by 2 times for 1 turn. 2 boosting effects for 4 classes only for 1 turn, but it's still completely crazy. This Nami, along with B2Ray, is the best damage booster in the game. Like, you want to boost your damage, just put one her or Ray or even both of them. 15 turns cooldown, a bit higher than G4, but it's still good. He gets quick damage reduction, slot being self reduction, and reduce no healing duration. Okay, my opinion about the legends of this batch. Just get them if you can. Get them, because one is the best captain and the other is one of the best subs also. Well, G4 is also a very good sub, but why you would use him as a sub? Okay, we're going to move into the units from the batch. I'm not going to comment on the captain ability because Chobro is also is not very good either. Okay, we start with Chobro, Chopper from Wolke Island. He's Fighter Cerebral, he has 5 slots with the Mic Break, 4 combo. He has a bit lower stats for a rare recruit. Only 1.3k attack, more or less. Has a bit more recovery. The Captain ability, yeah, like I said, not going to comment it. Sucks. The Silent ability, changes a lot into recovery at the start of the fight. This is pretty interesting, can be useful depending on some situations. The Limit Break Silent ability makes in orbs beneficial for fighter characters. Pretty useful. All orb beneficial sailors are pretty good. Now, the special. 12 turn cooldown. Reduces the defense of enemies by 80% for 1 turn. Reduces enemy threshold reduction and enrage duration by 5 turns. Makes in PSI Dex orb beneficial for all characters for 1 turn. And adds 6x chain multiplier for 1 turn. Bonkers. How to say it? Completely overpowered. You will say, wow, he doesn't do as much by himself, but wait until I come in the next unit, please. No healing duration. Cooldown reduction is pretty interesting because he can use his special sooner without stalling as much. Okay, not going to talk yet about him because he is very good, but he needs another unit to work even better. Carrot, Wolke Island Carrot, Fighter Free Spirit, 5 slots, stats better than Chopper, these are more decent rare equipped stats. Abilities, not going to talk about the Captain ability, resist paralysis completely, nice, boost attack and HP of Fighter by 40, okay. Special, reduces paralysis and despair duration by 4 turns, delays all enemies for 1 turn, changes Strange Dex Quick Int and PSI into PSI Orbs and boost attack against enemies with reduced defense by 175 for 1 turn. So this Carrot does combo combo with Chopper. As simple as that, because with this Carrot you will have full Orbs. You will have 175 conditional, 0.6 time multiplier, reduce a lot of things, delay the enemy. Basically, Carrot and Chopper are the Boa sisters of this batch. They are a combo of two units that works so good. She has Enrage for a nice amount of damage and critical hit. Next one. Brook, which is my other pick for MVP of this batch. He's a Slasher Free Spirit, 5 slots. The captain as always. If he has his Strength Orb, he will keep it. He also makes recovery and tandem magic from himself, and his special deal 8 hits of 20 characters in temples damage of 20 character attack in temples damage to random enemies. If enemies have the all debuff or the light debuff protection, he changes block orb into matching orbs and boosts the color affinity of all characters by 175 for 1 turn, so universal conditional affinity booster with 14 turn cooldown. He's pretty good. Like, this batch is crazy. I know we have G4 for conditional for universal affinity boosting, but he might not fit all the teams, like for example of my beloved Frankie. So yeah, this is also another very good unit to get like right away. Lastly, Pedro, which also has 5 slots. Boosts the character, the base attack of a slasher by 40 and makes Dex or beneficial for 6 characters, a bit meh. Puts the current HP of one enemy by 10%. If enemies have all the buff of the life debuff protection, amplifies the effect of orbs by 175 and boosts the attack of all characters by 175. This is also pretty good because it's a conditional double booster. It's a conditional booster that boosts attack and orbs. He doesn't fit as well with the other units, I mean, because depends on who your captain is. He gives what the other units don't give, but you may not need it. Not need it. 14 to cooldown, Strength Damage Reduction and Critical Hit. Okay, in my opinion, this batch, along with the Legends, is pretty damn good, honestly. There's going to be other units boosted, but if you can get the badge and one of the legends, you have scored hard. like this batch, these three are awesome. This one is also very good. Yeah, my review is that this Sugo Fest batch is pretty good. So it's up to you to decide if you want to pull or not. And now, lastly, before to use the same video for this, I'm going to talk about the newest Colosseum getting to Global, one of the best, if not the best, Colosseum units ever. He's going to change a lot of things. We are talking of Eustace Kid, Time Skip Kid, Colosseum. His Colosseum is made to be more easily beaten by the new batch, but you don't really need it. As always, you can do other things and he's going to beat them. Okay, he's a striker and shooter with 5 slots. 5 slots in a Colosseum unit. Chapeau. Perfect. Now, he has good stats. He has HP around 3k. He has a lot of attack. A lot of attack for what he does. What you will see now. Covery, okay. His captain ability is I will comment on it, but yeah, boost the attack of striker and shooter by 2.5 and deal damage at the end of the turn. If you are a newbie, and you get it on the medium difficulty Colosseum, good for you, but no one is going to use him as a captain. The seller ability, boost the attack, HP and recovery of dex characters by 20 and boost the base attack of strikers by 30. This is weak, honestly, but with how strong is the unit, I wouldn't ask more of him. Now, the special is what breaks this unit. Deals 5 hit of random dex damage to random enemies, reduces the special cooldown of striker and shooter specials by 2 turns, and if your captain is a striker or shooter character, deals 350 character attack as dex damage to the enemies at the end of the turn for 2 turns. This is about 600k damage. Dex damage, so it will deal less to strength and more to quick at the end of turn for 2 turns. It will also reduce the special cooldown of 2 types of units. He's amazing because he revolutionizes free-to-play zombie teams. He's also pretty good on striker teams. He's good in almost everything that can use him, and you need some clear area damage because his damage, if you can avoid barriers, his damage just kills every type of mob that's not a boss, will die to him. And we are not finished with him. He has 12 turn cooldown. You say, oh, he's a good cooldown, but I mean, zombie team won't have him ready in stage 1. That's where you're wrong, my friend, because he has cooldown reduction. This means his special will be ready at stage 1. His special will be ready at stage 1. And you will be able to use him and speedrun to the first two stages because he's also going to reduce 2 turns of your units. And since you are killing the units with end of turn damage, you're going to still gain a turn. You're not going to lose a turn of stalling. And his enrage goes to 200 attack. His enrage goes to 200 attack. So basically we have a unit that is very amazing at clearing mobs, which also has his special ready from the start of the stage. And yeah, and also reduces the special cooldown of your units. This is, I think, the best. Maybe a bit later, Daifuku gives him a bit of competition, but Daifuku is not for the same purpose of him. I think Kid is probably the best Colosseum unit ever released. He's going to have a day of skill up at the start, so I would say max him. Go with all you have and max this unit because this unit is amazing. Again, I'm sorry to say it so many times, but that's the truth. Okay, so to sum it up, guys, G4 batch, excellent. If you can spare a few pulls, do it, because if you get them, you're going to be pretty happy with the result. Time skip Colo Kid, most max, day 1, max him. If you can, max him as soon as possible. This is going to change so many things on zombie teams, on speedrun teams, and even he's useful on normal teams that can use him, striker and shooter. So yeah, guys, this is my review on the newest units coming to Global. So thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.